If Kingston Town was a hero, and he most definitely was, Gurner's Lane will go down as a villain on Melbourne Cup Day in 1982.
That coming up shortly, Gurner's Lane goes in. Lights on, and they're off to a great start in the Melbourne Cup.
You couldn't get a more popular cup runner than the three-time Cox Plate winner. But there was no room for sentiment from Gurner's Lane.
Back on the inside, perfectly positioned Kingston Town.
From barrier 22 of 23, Mick Dittman kept Gurner's Lane out of sight and out of mind, as every set of eyes at Flemington hoped, dreamed, and even prayed for Kingston Town to add a Melbourne Cup to a burgeoning mantelpiece.
Gurner's Lane is back in centre field as they round the turn.
Gurner's Lane had the luxury of a 3 kilo weight pull on Kingston Town, but there was still a lot of work to do on the home turn.
Inside triumphal march, and Kingston Town with a rattling run, 400 to go. Kingston Town is ranging up on the outside to take the lead from Noble Comet.
No one would dare ruin this sporting fairy tale, would they?
Avon coming home strongly on the outside. Kingston Town, Port Carling, and Gurner's Lane on the inside might beat them all. Gurner's Lane. Gurner's Lane has got up to win the cup. He came through to beat Kingston Town and Mick.
A superb staying effort from Gurner's Lane, but it wasn't meant to happen. The scriptwriters already had the mighty Kingston Town's name engraved on the trophy. Instead, Gurner's Lane will go down as both a Melbourne Cup hero and villain.